Well, I've pretty much reviewed all of the Walking With series so far, all of which I grew up loving as a kid, but the last one, Walking With Cavemen, I only saw recently. Nonetheless, I still enjoyed it a lot, as it was well made and taught me a lot more about human evolution than I knew. Perhaps what I was most pleased with was the fact that costumes and makeup on human actors were used instead of CGI, like in that episode of Walking With Prehistoric Beasts. I have to give credit to the production team, the effects look quite convincing, and each new species of human has its own unique appearance, allowing us to see progression as time goes on, with the characters becoming more and more human-like. I'm a big fan of the soundtrack, too. It may not be the Jurassic theme from Walking with Dinosaurs, but it does have that exciting tune that fits the subject of the documentary very well. The series begins with a clan of upright-walking apes called Afarensis on the plains of Africa. The famous fossil Lucy is made into a main character for this segment, depicted as a mother to a small baby. Her tribe is engaged in a territorial dispute with a rival clan, while at the same time, two males within Lucy's own tribe fight to replace the recently killed leader and take over the group. Although they look slightly human, they act pretty much like ordinary apes, which makes sense. The filmmakers are trying to show exactly when apes started to evolve into us, and this first segment starts us off with animals we can easily associate with the ones we're familiar with today. Next, we move on to find three separate species of intelligent apes, and the episode doesn't tell us which one will evolve into humans, a clever way of keeping things interesting. There's the scary-looking Boisei, which look like a cross between gorillas and orangutans that walk like humans. The even scarier Habilis, which look very much like people, but covered with scraggly hair. And the chimpanzee-like Rudolphensis, which, more than anything else, look like the ape men from the 2001 Lost World. I really like this shot of the Rudolphensis clan standing in a line with the sun behind them so they look more shadowy. It's a pretty frightening image. Aside from their differing looks, each ape species is shown to have different human behavior, with Habilis showing themselves resourceful, picking apart a beehive for the honey inside and working together to chase off a lion, while Boisei seems comparatively laid back. We later travel to the next stage in evolution to meet Ergaster, which have started to develop many traits we take for granted, but are actually unique to us as human beings. Things like the ability to track animals by logically determining from footprints that an animal went in a certain direction, or the ability to create language and communicate with each other in more sophisticated ways. Most noticeably, the tribe we focus on is tied together by family instead of one dominant male, like in earlier, more primitive apes. I especially like this iconic scene of the hunters walking across a salt plain in pursuit of a dying wildebeest, with one of the men carrying a crocodile tooth in his mouth. It's a pretty unforgettable image. Next, we travel to Asia to meet Erectus, which looks similar to Ergaster, but in a much different environment. They happen across a giant ape called Gigantopithecus, brought to life by a puppet. There's a very thought-provoking scene here where a member of the group dies and the others simply leave him behind. Some well-written narration tells us that although these people look and act like us, they still live in an animalistic lifestyle that doesn't honor the dead. Their mindset is so literal that they don't have imagination, ceremonies, and other things we have nowadays.
Unlike you and me, these people can only see the world around them as it is. They can't do what we take for granted and picture worlds of a different kind.
Finally, we make it to the Ice Age to see Neanderthals, as one certain tribe is faced with a tough decision where winter is closing in and they need to move to find more food and supplies, but the leader's wife is pregnant and in no position to travel great distances, so they have to go on one last hunt that will determine if they can settle down. The actors here do a particularly good job displaying the conflict they feel and how much is depending on their next choice, all without any real words being spoken. We learn a lot about Neanderthals, as they are able to sustain horrendous injuries and simply walk them off, and how they are intelligent enough to hunt mammoths by pushing a boulder off a cliff to bring one down. Popular culture seems to think of Neanderthals as stupid cavemen, but this documentary shows that they were actually quite well suited to their habitat and very successful for the time being. It's only the end of the Ice Age and our Homo sapien ancestors being more intelligent and imaginative that makes us the dominant species of human in the end. So, as expected, Walking with Cavemen was yet another solid entry in BBC's Prehistoric series, and maybe the one I learned the most new information from. I knew almost nothing about human evolution before watching it, and it taught me a lot of new things, which I think is the highest compliment you can give a documentary.